probably smoke the folks around here. Didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business. No one dared to make a slip. Stranger there among them. And a big iron on his head. Big iron on his head. It was early in the morning. He rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw, loose and running, came a whisper from each lip. He's here to do some business with the big iron on his head, the big iron on his head. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, the youth of 24. And the notches on his pistol, number 1 and 19 more. 1 and 19 more. Stranger started talking, made a plain to folks around. He was an Arizona Ranger, wouldn't be long in town. He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas Red, and after Texas Red. It wasn't long before the story was related to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry when they tried to call it dead. 20 men had tried to take it. 20 men had made the slip. 21 would be the ranger. Big iron on his head. Big iron on his head. So it was time for them to meet. It was 11:20, and they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death. About to meet his death. There was 40 foot between them, and they stopped to make their play. The swiftness of the Rangers to talk about today. Texas Red, knuckle leather, bullet, bullet, fairly ripped. And the Rangers' aim was deadly with the big iron on his head. The big iron on his head. Well, it was over in a moment, and the folks had gathered round. They laid the body. Body out on the ground. Well, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip, and he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his head. The big iron on his head.
Hell yeah, man.